If you have not heard, Anita Sarkeesian, founder of Feminist Frequency and best known for her controversial Tropes vs. Woman in Video Games YouTube series, visited Bioware Edmonton late last month. Anita is a very problematic figure who's known for being hypocritical and pushing misinformation just to attempt to prove her point. A lot of people in the media seem to ignore these issues and denounce her critics simply as trolls. Now, we would really have to sit down here for a very long time to go over why she can be toxic and why I think she does more bad than good for her cause. But today I received some information about her visit to BioWare in which there are some developers not happy about it. But before we get into that, for those who don't know who she is, here's a short clip of her on the Colbert Report a few years ago.
Would you call them male fantasy games or male some fantasy of objectification of women games?
Some of them, that would be an accurate title.
Give me some names.
So in the work that I do, I look at hundreds of examples of video games.
Can you think of three?
I can, but I think it's a bigger issue to talk about the industry as a whole and how it perpetuates these ideas of sexism and misogyny as opposed to just Grand Theft Auto, for example.
So on January 25th, Anita Sarkeesian tweeted, "I had such a great time touring at BioWare Edmonton's office and having tea with a great group of women and allies. Thanks for your hospitality." This was met with uproar from the gaming community, some pointing this to the downfall of BioWare, some simply mocking the photo, and some just saying some very vile things. But I will say my initial reaction was, why would Electronic Arts allow this to happen? Mainly because of the extreme backlash that came a few years ago with Mirror's Edge Catalyst, in which some rumors popped up saying that she was consulting on the game, leading to a petition titled "Remove Anita Sarkeesian from Mirror's Edge 2 Game Development," which was signed by over 54,000 people and pretty much stated that she is problematic. Eventually, Electronic Arts actually responded by saying the petition is based on inaccurate information. EA is not working with Anita Sarkeesian on development of Mirror's Edge. Anyway, let's now get into her visit at BioWare Edmonton. Now, the same source I spoke to about Anthem's status back in December gave me this information, in which I was told that some developers are pretty pissed that she was brought into the studio. She apparently was brought in and asked to speak to some of the developers that quote-unquote fawn over her, and then she even got to have a look at some of Anthem and give her opinion on it. From what I was told, everyone was nice to her while she was there, with some putting fake smiles on, but afterwards the official quote I received about the situation and that she tweeted about her visit was, "The amount of fire and negativity that came out of the office about her toxic nature was pretty clear." And apparently some of the higher-ups of the studio took notice, stating that they hear all sides, but that the developers who are unhappy about her visit should know that there are more pressing issues like the game itself that they should worry about. As noted by OneGamer.net, this is not the first time BioWare, well, in that case BioWare Montreal, had problem or outrage over certain individuals and their views. Former longtime BioWare developer Manvir Hare, who worked on Mass Effect Andromeda, was, well, he is, a very controversial and racist individual who over the years posted some very disturbing things on Twitter, like the following tweet, which says, "White people, I am not here to make you feel comfortable or okay with yourself or the white supremacy you benefit from." And there's a lot more tweets, as you can see on the screen, with some just really outrageous. Manvir Hare eventually was fired before Andromeda's release, but that wasn't before a lot of gamers claimed that they would boycott the game because of his tweets. Furthermore, there was anger at release when it was found that in the character creator there was a limit on the skin tone option and players were not able to make their character pale. BioWare's lead game designer, Ian S. Fraser, responded to one fan's complaints of this issue by saying, "There are some limits to the tone range based on the texture of the actual scanned head. We're looking into fixing via patch." Eventually this would be fixed, but again, some link to this issue to Manvir Hare and his tweets. But let's be honest, Mass Effect Andromeda was just a nightmare of a game altogether.
"To who?
To whom? And your goddamn father?
Sorry, my face is tired.
Personally, again, I think it's a very odd decision to let Anita Sarkeesian come to the studio, especially with the outrage in the past. The only thing that really bothers me a little is having her look at some of Anthem, almost like some of the people involved in the game are looking for approval. Either way, it seems that not all of BioWare was happy about this, with one developer feeling sick to their stomach over some of the things that she said. Anyway, I did manage to get my own update on Anthem, and there is good news as the game is improving, at least from a technical standpoint. My source said that right now they feel like they have a hit, but the main issue is going to get people playing the game because of the whole Battlefront 2 mess. But microtransactions are still undecided, and that certainly will play a role. Gameplay-wise, combat is being worked on to be more intense, and the game overall has been described to me as being a lot like Mass Effect with an open-world feel, but each fight is basically in a mini arena. Pretty much you enter a certain area, fight the spawn, and move on. Anyway guys, what do you make of Anita Sarkeesian's visit? Let me know down in the comment section below. Thank you for watching. If you did enjoy this video or found any informative value, make sure to leave a like and consider subscribing for more videos like this, and I'll see you later.